It is the true essence of the word derby this weekend in North London. Yes, it's a good one. It always is. It's unpredictable. It's nasty. It's volatile. Really, anything can happen. Now, could you believe that about 2.5 weeks ago now, Spurs were in first place in the Premier League. The Gunners, dead last. And how the Spurs faithful rejoiced in that hilarity, right? Well, calm down, Spurs fans. Since then, your boys have lost 2 straight games. Arsenal have won 2 straight games. And guess what? In the table, a win for Arsenal this weekend. And yet dead even. Mikel Arteta has his team playing much tighter football, and partly that's because Thomas Partey is back at the party. He's been fantastic and is key in that midfield going forward. As for Spurs, it's all about Harry Kane, isn't it? Harry Kane playing so deep the last couple of weeks, and time is in that left channel. He's got to be back up top scoring goals. So maybe you could be seeing a formation change this weekend to get the best out of Harry Kane, who just does not look happy after that whole transfer turmoil this summer. Add in that the Gunners at home against Spurs, they really enjoy their football, unbeaten in 25 of the past 27 games. This one will be tight. It's going to be a derby. I'm thinking a very low scoring draw. This one for me might be the match of the weekend. Leeds against West Ham. The Northern team play champagne football every time they hit the field. They're so much fun to watch. Maybe the most fun watch in all of the Premier League, but they're not winning games at this point. In fact, winless on the season at this point. And are missing Patrick Bamford, their star striker, for this weekend. So West Ham should be drooling at the opportunity to score 3 points. The Hammers, of course, coming off a big win midweek against Manchester United in the Carabao Cup, having lost to United on the weekend, last weekend. Now, West Ham are playing really good football right now. David Moyes has the fans on board at the moment, but they're away from home in this one, but should welcome back Mikel Antonio from suspension. West Ham, one of the early season stories thus far in this year's Premier League, and expect West Ham to win on the road. The Toffees are enduring a horrendous injury streak at the moment, missing some key players, including Dominic Calvert-Lewin and Richarlison. So where are the goals coming from this weekend for Rafa Benitez and company, who came back down to earth with a thud midweek, losing the QPR of the championship in the Carabao Cup? They also lost last weekend, of course, but the good news is Everton, you're playing Norwich. Norwich are struggling thus far in the Premier League. They've lost 15 straight games in the Prem, going back to the last stint in the Prem a couple of years ago now. Daniel Fox's team playing some good football at times, even last week against Liverpool. They play good at times, but still lost 3-0. It's going to be a long season, I think, and it's back against the Merseyside club this weekend. Expect Everton with a relatively easy win. Let's be honest, Leicester's better than they've shown so far this season, and I really think Burnley are better than they've shown this season as well. That being said, Burnley have lost 7 of 8 games in the Premier League dating back to last season. There are issues with Sean Dyche and company. Has he been there just a bit too long? We're going to find out. That being said, they found the goals and found goals galore midweek in the Carabao Cup, beating mighty Rochdale 4-1. But maybe it's a confidence booster. That being said, Leicester, as I mentioned, are much better than they've shown so far. They also won midweek, but they're looking pretty good at home as well against Burnley, unbeaten in 10 games. Expect Leicester to keep piling on the hurt on poor Sean Dyche and Burnley this weekend. I'm going to say it right now, Brentford have been the story thus far in this year's Premier League. First timers at the top flight and unbeaten until last weekend, playing some lovely football along the way. The trouble is, the form might not continue because they're playing Liverpool, who I think are reverting back to type of a couple of years ago when they were the champions, of course. They look formidable right now. They're pretty much healthy once again. They're just not conceding goals, with Virgil van Dijk and Joel Matip forming perhaps the best centre-back partnership thus far in the league season. And up front, of course, Mo Salah. He looks like the best player in the league at the moment. They're just dominating teams. They've won 9 of the past 10 going back to last season. Brentford, love you. Love your fans. Love your story. But this is going to be a big reality check.